You went to Nashville 11 looking for a record deal, huh?
I did, actually.
Yeah, with a couple demo tapes from karaoke songs.
Yeah, that was...
That's pretty cool to do.
That was before I played guitar or wrote my own music. And I think that trip really made me realize that there are girls in Nashville who are gorgeous and have amazing voices and want to do the same thing that I wanted to do. And I had to figure out a way to stand out.
Yep, you did.
And for me, I went back home and I started playing a guitar and writing my own music. And in that sense, I could walk into a room and play my own instrument and I could play songs that I'd written, and that way I wouldn't have to depend on anybody creatively.
You play a 12-string guitar?
I do, actually, yeah.
Why did you pick 12 over the conventional?
Well, I took a bunch of lessons when I was little, really little, like 10 and 11 and stuff, guitar on 6-strings, and I had this one real jerk of a teacher who I was asking him, I was like, so what's the difference between a 6-string and 12-string guitar? And he goes, I don't even need to answer that for you because there's no way that you'll be able to play a 12-string guitar at your age, and your fingers aren't developed enough, and there's no way you'd be able to play it. So the next day I picked out the 12-string guitar that I wanted, and and waited, I think, about 6 months until Christmas came around, and I got that 12-string guitar, and I would play it every single day until my fingers bled.
Wow.
And, you know, at first it seemed really hard, and then I just realized that if I put my mind to something, then it was really mind over matter, and maybe my fingers weren't long enough or developed enough to play it, but I played it.
Wow.
And so, you know, it's really exciting to see that, you know, ha, guitar teacher.
There you go.
That's kind of why. I mean, for me, I'm really competitive and I'm really stubborn, so if you tell me I can't do something, I'm
gonna
go do it.
You're going to get it done, too. You're going to get it done. How much input did you have in the whole process of recording this CD?
I had a lot of
input. A lot of creative input.
You know, there was never a recording session where they were tracking instruments that I wasn't there.
Okay.
And, you know, asking, hey, Nathan, can you turn this up? I need to hear a little more mandolin or, you know, different songs that have piano, different things. You know, when I write a song, I hear how it's supposed to sound in my head. And I can hear the production. I can hear what the drums are doing. And, you know, I can hear what the mandolin's doing, what the bass is doing, what everything is doing when I'm writing that song. So usually when we go into the studio, all I have to do is sit down with Nathan for about 10 minutes and say, look, this is how I want this to sound, and he just puts it all to life.
Wow. Wow. You're the first female artist to go top 10 since Gretchen Wilson did 3 years ago?
Yeah.
That's a cool...
It's very exciting.
That's cool.
It's really exciting because, you know, radio has just been so great to me, and I went out on about a 6-month radio tour, I think. A lot of artists go out on a 6-week radio tour, and I wanted to go out and I wanted to meet everybody that I possibly could, and so it really paid off, and the people who called in and requested this song, I owe them so much because they're the ones that kept the song going, and it ended up being a top 5 single for me.
I read where it says, I consider myself a songwriter first foremost, and I have never written anything I don't mean. Is that a true statement?
That is a true statement.
Okay.
I think that's on my MySpace. On my MySpace,
I don't know where I picked that up.
On my MySpace, I tried to write my biography not, you know, as somebody else was writing it. You know, a lot of artists have, so-and-so is the best, you know, musician ever. And I just didn't want to have my biography be like that. So I decided to write mine first person.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, telling about who I am as a person, what I like, what I don't like, what annoys me, what I love, you know, stuff like that. And I thought, because I always wanted my favorite artists to do that.
Mm-hmm.
I always thought it would have been cool if the country artists that I looked up to when I was little would have given the fans something really cool, some real personal information, not too personal, but just what their favorite food is. Stuff like that. You know, you never hear that kind of stuff, and I always thought it was kind of cool.
What did I read from? Maybe it was on MySpace. What's your favorite food? Cheesecake.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I read that.
So I thought it was pretty cool to give these people information about me, because I'm not scared of it.
No, why not? What's wrong with cheesecake?
I don't have anything to hide.
No, I like cheesecake, too.
I know.
Yeah. What's your website?
My website is www.taylorswift.com, or hit me up on MySpace, which is myspace.com/Taylor Swift.
Okay. Advice. You have any advice for anybody that wants to, you know... So what did you learn so far that you would give advice to?
How long do you have?
Yeah, stay with it.
You know, there's so many things that you learn throughout the way, and I had so many people give me, you know, advice when I was younger, and I can't say that I listened to any of it.
Right.
All the lessons that I learned, I had to learn by myself.
And
I think this is one of the professions that you really have to learn by doing it.
Right.
And, you know, you don't learn how to not have stage fright by hearing somebody give you advice about it.
That's true.
You learn how to not have stage fright by getting up on stage 300 times in a row to the point where it feels like you're just standing on your bedroom singing to the mirror.
That's it.